personal protective equipment, PPE, is super important. We use it in all of our daily efforts, and we need to continue to use it and use it right. I think the solution most of us have seen recently and like are disposable face shields. They tend to be lightweight. There's a little sponge across the forehead, an elastic band, and a Mylar shield. I would ask that when you choose your face shield, that you make sure you're getting one. And when I say make sure, what I mean here is most of us who are on the clinical forefront aren't the ones ordering supplies. And so whether it's going through your charge nurse or talking to your purchasing office or whomever it is, if you notice that your face shields don't go around and give you nice side protection, it's important to ask for a model that does that. We don't want to take the chance of being splashed from the side. Less common in most of what we do is being splashed from below. If you're doing something like dumping something out of a container into a hopper, there is the possibility of something splashing upwards. And if that's the case, you also need to make sure that your face shield goes down past your chin if possible. So those are some reminders about eye protection. The last thing I'll say is safety glasses that many of us use in emergency department settings. We see them there the most often. They're handy. They're great to protect your eyes against shards of something hard. For example, if you're using an oscillating saw to do a procedure, you don't want to get a fleck of something in your eye. They're good for that, but they're not as reliable for many splashes and aerosol exposures. And so if that's what you're using, you need to take a careful look at them and make sure that they are at least as good at covering your eyes as a face shield would be. If they're not, then I would grab a face shield and work with that. So that's eye protection. And then the last thing is a respirator. Those of you who work in acute care hospitals have respiratory protection programs where you're fit tested. The gold standard here is to use a respirator for which you're fit tested and to use it correctly, which means A, it has to be worn properly. It needs to be pinned firmly against your nose and against your face. If you have whiskers like mine, then they need to be completely on the inside of your respirator. If they're crossing the edge, they break the seal. Let's talk a moment about what respirators do. They are a barrier for splashes, that's good, but they are more importantly a filter. And the way they work is they allow you to breathe air that is filtered through the material. If there's leakage on the sides, they don't filter as well. Now, the use of respirators is something that is, like goggles, very uncomfortable. None of us loves them. Some places are using PAPRs or elastomeric, so those are other respirators. Respirators only work if they're used correctly and if they're used the whole time that you're with your patient or with a procedure happening where you need to wear one. And so anytime you have to take it off because you're having trouble breathing, or if there's that annoying tickle of sweat on the inside of the respirator that's driving you nuts, you need to leave the area, right? And if you're about to touch your face, you probably need to take your gloves off, do hand hygiene, do what you're gonna do, and then start again.